Hi, in this tutorial we will learn how to do something like this, this structure. And we will start from scratch. I will start by creating the contour. In shape I will use an arc. Click, drag, release and set the radius. Now I will add a lathe modifier. Now in lathe modifier, if you choose min, the axis of revolution will be placed in the farthest point on the left. That means here, as you can see. If I choose center, the axis will be in the center. If I choose max, the axis will be in the farthest right place. So I will choose min. Of course you can click the axis and move it to create something like this if you like. Now I will click min. Now as you can see, the resolution is 88. That means Max created 88 copy from this contour around this axis. You can choose the resolution you want. I will reduce it. By default it's 16, but I was working on this file before, so I will make it, let's say, 64. And something else, by default this option here is off. If you look here you can see some artifacts. This is because we have 64 vertices in the same place. So when you click weld core, these vertices will be welded together and now they are just one vertex. Now for this shape I will use the graphite tools, and to be able to do that I need to convert this to an editable poly, or I can add an edit poly modifier. From here I can choose from the polygon modeling drop down this tool here called Generate Topology. I will choose this pattern, and as you can see I get the pattern that I want. Now what I need to do is to create a separate spline object from these edges. So I will go to edge sub-object level. In the front viewport I will select all the edges except the top one. You can select the top one if you like, if you like to create some kind of a ring. It's up to you, it doesn't matter for this exercise. And now to create a spline object based on these segments, I will click here in this create shape. I will click this button, the settings button. I will give it a name. I will choose linear to respect the shape of these segments. Sometimes if you choose smooth, these segments will be smoothed in a way that they don't follow exactly the shape of these segments. So I will click OK. Now I have my spline object. To be able to select it you need to go out from the sub-object level of the poly. I will right click and hide. Now I have this. Now to give it a thickness, all you have to do is enable enable these two options. This one, enable in viewport, will let you see the thickness that you can see here. You can see it in the viewport. Clicking this one will help you to see, will let you see the thickness in the rendering, because by default 2D splines, they don't render, but now when you enable this, they will render. Now you might see some artifact here. Let's try to reduce the thickness. Now if you still see this, now these vertices here, they are all welded, so I will, in the front viewport, I will turn off temporarily. I will go to vertex and I will select this vertex and I will break it. Now as you can see, I have 64 vertices. Now when they are exploded, if I enable the thickness again, you can see that you don't see this artifact. Now we get our shape. You can play with the thickness by increasing this value. Also, you can, instead of a circular profile, you can choose a rectangular profile. You can decide the width and height. I will give it a 0.2 for the length, and well, we got some interesting shape here. Not bad. So, and I can give this one a 0.4. Also, I can play with the angle. You can twist, let's say if I make them 45. I will make it radial again. And from now on, you can turn on unhide this shape here, and you can give it like a glass material. Of course, it's better if you give it some thickness. You can add a shell with a small amount, 0.05, something like that. And yeah, that's it for this tutorial. If you like it, please press the like button, subscribe to the channel. If you have any suggestion, please leave them in the comments area, and see you next time. Thank you.